Lijep pozdrav, dragi gledatelji. Lijep pozdrav iz Manchestera, iz Engleske. Znam da znate rezultat utakmice Manchester City Dinamo, ali sigurno ne znate ni vi, dragi frenderi, što se sve dešavalo prije i za vrijeme utakmice. Budite s nama, ostanite s nama, bez obzira na stupove koji mi se pod noge bacaju. Biće zanimljivo, vidjet ćete puno zabavnih i nevjerojatnih stvari.
Dinamo!
Manchester je grad na zapadu Engleske, 60 km od Irskog kanala, ima oko pola milijuna stanovnika. Nogometno je poznat po Manchester Unitedu i Cityu, a glazbeno po cijelom nizu bendova, poput Oasis, braće Gallagher, Joy Division, Smithsi, Stone Roses, Simply Red, Bee Gees, Buzzcocks, Chemical Brothers i još masu drugih. Nije ni čudo kad ovdje stalno pada kiša, pa što ti preostaje nego svirka u garaži ili natkrivena tribina. Za početak, odlučili smo se za obilazak grada u kojem će nas opaki Joe za 7 funti provesti ključnim nogometnim točkama Manchestera.
Okay, so behind me we've got the Royal Buildings, which was a hotel, and there's a plaque on the side, and in 1888 this is where the Football League was founded by William McKenzie, who was the Aston Villa chairman, and there were 12 teams in that league.
And who was the mother and who was the father of the Premier League?
The father figure was William McKenzie, because he was the Aston Villa chairman, and the first team to win it was Preston North End. That's why we say that Preston is also the home of football.
Zabavan je podatak da je Premier Ligu osvojilo samo 6 klubova. Blackburn Rovers, Arsenal, Chelsea, Leicester, te dva iz Manchestera, United i City.
And the most important question, how many people support United, how many people support City? And what is the differences?
So Manchester United, judging by the home attendances, obviously they get 75,000 people, but how many are from Manchester? Most people probably aren't out of that. And Manchester City have a reputation for having more local supporters. Obviously, they're not quite at the attendance at United at the moment, but yeah, so it's a tricky one. Manchester United fans say that all City fans live in Stockport, and City fans say that most United fans live in London. So that's okay. It.
A sada, zvijezdani trač. Nogometni, naravno.
So behind me, we have Rio Ferdinand's restaurant, Rosso.
Rosso, what kind of restaurant?
Italian restaurant.
Italian?
Yeah.
Is he Italian?
No. Not Italian.
Is he cooking inside?
No. So what's the connection? Don't know.
A tu preko puta je dućan Liama Gallaghera, pjevača Oasisa i velikog navijača Citya. Inače o njemu sam zadnji put čitao kada je navodno za svoj brend posudio grb Hajduka.
I went to school with Liam actually, and I remember him playing football. He was a great footballer. He played in for our year. He was a year below me, but he played in our year. So he was a striker, a great footballer.
No, to je samo jedna od hrpe nogometnih priča u Manchesteru. Ajmo dalje.
A sada mjesto koje ste svi čekali. Dakle, nalazimo se ispred puba gdje je George Best, vidite njegovu sliku na dimnjaku, stuko svoju karijeru.
Tell me about this place.
The thing is, it's where George Best used to drink, and he was sort of like the first rock and roll footballer. And he used to play for Manchester United, obviously, you know that. Maybe people know that now, but when he arrived in Manchester, he got in the back of a taxi. And the taxi driver says to him, where do you want to go? So George Best says, I want to go to Old Trafford, the ground. And the taxi driver said, which ground? Because Old Trafford was famous for the cricket as well as the football, and he genuinely didn't know which one he wanted to go to.
Očito je taksist odlučio kojim će se sportom baviti Best, koji je više pomogao pubu nego sebi. Jer ovo je mjesto danas turistička atrakcija, ali i točka gdje se redovito okupljaju navijači Uniteda od 0 do 77.
You may know George Best as the first rock and roll footballer. He had a couple of quotes. One was, in 1969, I gave up women and alcohol. It was the worst 20 minutes of my life. And the other one was, I spent all my money on booze, birds and fast cars, and the rest I squandered. What a character. There he is.
Ljudi, je li vama ova Bestova slika baca na Niku Krančara?
Evo, dragi prijatelji, kao i svaki puta u reportažama s Lige prvaka, pokušavamo vam predstaviti i stadion na kojem se igra, ovaj puta naravno Manchester City. Stadion je dosta impozantan, izvana kao betonski svemirski brod koji je sletio, puno sajli nekakvih koji drže krov i puno zanimljivosti na samom stadionu. kao na primjer na puževima po kojima se penju i spuštaju navijači su imena što navijačkih klubova, što samih navijača s godišnjom ulaznicom. Dakle, ovdje se navijači zaista cijene. Njihova imena su ispisana na stadion.
Hi.
Hi, you're gonna phone with us, aren't you?
Oh, great.
Hello, sir. Nice, you okay? You. Hi, guys.
Hi.
You okay?
Oh, oh buras. Tu se fino, papa. Čekaj, su mi... Jel mi razgledamo restoran ili kužiš ili stadion?
This is the hospitality area where people get to eat before the game. It's you know...
Oh, players?
Fans. So you come here, you buy a ticket, you get to have a tapas kind of meal, you get drinks, you get beer, you get a program for the match, and then you get the all the players come where you've walked right through here, and then they go down into their changing rooms.
You can sit in here,
you can sit here, have a
beer, watch your favorite
players. They come right here, you can give them high fives, very exclusive. It's not too exclusive, but you have to pay a bit extra than a normal ticket.
How much?
But it, you know,
approximately,
so, approximately for around say £500-600 for a match.
Za razliku od Citya, gostujući tim ima manje glamurozan ulaz.
Your team, Dinamo Zagreb,
yes.
They wouldn't come this way. They go a different way.
Where from?
So they from here.
Back door.
Yes.
From the...
So you see the hedge?
From the garage.
They go underground. Yeah, like Danger Mouse. Underground, and then they pull up. All for safety, so that they're looked after, and then we bring them through to the back. Let's go.
U gostujućoj svlačionici zatekli smo i grupu tvrdih navijača Dinama.
Can I hear from you Dinamo Zagreb?
No.
Please, Dinamo!
Dinamo!
Louder!
Dinamo!
Much more!
Dinamo!
Big hands! Dinamo!
Dinamo!
One more, one, two, three.
This is your changing room. It's very hot in here. The cameraman, I'm sure you guys can feel it. There's a reason why it's very warm. It's all about the psychology of Manchester City. So, yeah, but it's quite hot.
Siva boja svlačionice u kojoj će se skidati Dinamo čini mi se dosta depresivno. Je li to namjerno da se obeshrabri gostujuća momčad?
Well, it's going to be depressing playing City anyway because City is such a good side. So when you know that Kevin De Bruyne is in the other team, you know that's depressing enough. So welcome everybody to the home team dressing room. So this is where the players will be getting ready for the game tomorrow. I'm just going to go and put some of these shirts up so when the other guys come in. These aren't their real shirts, these are replica shirts. A lot of the players have superstitions. So they have, you know, like with the shin pads. Kyle Walker, if you have a look over here. Kyle Walker, he's kept the same shin pad since he was very young, since he was 12, 13 years old around then. And he still plays with the same shin pads now.
Svarno si mlad. Carson? Opa, di si Carson. Oh my God. Gabriel, Jesus is a girl.
It's the same size, believe it or not, as the opposition dressing room. Although it's a different shape, it is the same size. It looks bigger because it's brighter, all the lockers are white, and it just looks a little bit prettier. So, but there are 25 lockers exactly the same as the other dressing room. Lockers are slightly different though, because as you can see, they've got doors on. And that, you might think, causes a bit of a barrier when one player wants to talk to the other, but the actual doors fold in. So they've thought of everything really. And then behind the scene tab, there's even a small safe. So if the players want to lock anything away, they can use that.
For the goals?
Seats are all, yeah, for the watches and the phones. So you'll notice that one of the lockers is not occupied by a player's name. There are just 24 names up at the moment. So we're waiting to hear who's actually going to be brought into the squad to fill that space. Most of the other names will be familiar to you. Anybody any idea who the captain is this year? David Silva, yeah. And David Silva sits here. Traditionally, the captain would sit in the centre of the dressing room. But David, again, is very superstitious. He's always sat here and he doesn't want to move his locker position. So David is remaining here.
Kada izađu iz svoje svlačionice, igrači prolaze jedan zanimljiv ritual koji uveo Guardiola.
Just before the players are about to go onto the pitch, again, probably before they go to play your team tomorrow, Champions League, this will go up, and behind it is photos of the players' families, loved ones, children, nieces, nephews, people who are very close to them. And it's the last thing they see before they go onto the pitch. Give them a kiss, photos, and off they go, and it'll come back down.
We live together during 11 months, 7 3 weeks from holidays. So, all year, so, and we are here, don't respect each other, we try to make our lives easier. So, an important part of our lives is where you work, when you work. Go in there, wake up in the morning, say, oh, why, I'm going to work, I'm going to, you know, to have fun with my job, with the people I'm working with. So that is the secret of the life, so that's why we try. But before the family, of course, it's important, you have to win games. If you don't win games, the big father fire you, and you have to look for another job, another place.
This is the home dugout where I'm sat now. Is where Guardiola, Mr. Pep Guardiola, will be sitting here on the match day. This is nice and heated seats for the players.
What if you have a rain?
Get wet. It's Manchester. You're going to get wet. When you come here, always make sure you have a very nice coat. Make sure you have a nice hood, and you'll always keep dry. Well, that's just it. Manchester weather, you do get wet. Pep Guardiola doesn't worry about that, though. He only worries about the football. He's not bothered about being wet.
Pitam se da li su Guardioli u ugovoru rekli da će stalno biti mokar. A za oko nam je zapeo i teren sa nevjerovatno niskom travom. Neviđeno, nikad viđeno.
Pep Guardiola grows the pitch to a certain length so that they can have a good quick football. Make sure it's always nice and wet, nice and short, so that the football can be quick, very quick for passing and a very nice surface.
Wait a minute. He can decide how tall will be grass?
Yeah, so anybody can, yes. Yeah. So there's a limit of how high the grass needs to be. And Pep Guardiola chooses it to be closest to the shortest that it can be. And it's perfect for a very quick passing style of football.
Draga ekipa, sada načulite uši nešto što siguran sam niste nikad čuli ni vidjeli u životu. Ono, stvarno bizarno, a u isto vrijeme je tužno.
Prvi puta u životu vidim groblje u sklopu stadiona, točnije koji metar od tribina.
Okay, so this is a beautiful memorial garden that City have put together for any fans that have passed away who've been supporters, young, old, anybody who would like maybe their ashes to be scattered in the garden, they can be scattered here on request. It's just a beautiful area where people can come and they can remember their loved ones. Who love City dearly, and I think that's an absolutely beautiful.
What does it mean? Do you have funerals here?
No, so they won't have funerals, but there'll be a place where they can come with the ashes, and they'll probably have a little separate service with the family themselves, and then they'll pop them on there.
How many dead people wait here?
I couldn't say. I don't know exactly. But
dozens.
Yeah, there's a few, and it's about them all coming together and showing how much support and how much love. You know, they had for City and also Manchester City have for them. We don't just remember the people who are here, we remember the people who aren't here. And that's what Manchester City is all about. You know, it's about the community, about family, about love and support.
Ono što je interesantno, na nekim mjestima smo vidjeli otac i djed jedan do drugoga. Pivske flaše, šalovi, dakle, neke memorabilije vezane uz pokojnike, sve to ovdje na jednom mjestu. Nevjerojatno. Evo, ne znam kako bi vam to opisao i predočio, jer sam iskreno i sam šokiran s ovim. Ludo.
Iako večeras Dinamo igra protiv City-a, ne možemo ne spomenuti njihovog najvećeg gradskog rivala, Manchester United. Jer tu su tenzije, kako to i biva među susjedima. Sugrađanima, čak.
Old Trafford sa 74.879 mjesta najveći stadion u Britaniji i dom je Uniteda, najuspješnijeg engleskog kluba sa 20 naslova prvaka, 12 FA Cupa i 3 lige prvaka. City je pak osvojio 6 naslova prvaka i 6 FA Cupa, a njihov stadion prima 55.000. Netrpeljivost između Uniteda i City-a posebno jaka bila 70-ih kada je George Best slomio nogu u Pardou. A 73. su dva igrača oba kluba dobila crveni i odbili izaći s terena, pa je sudac obje momčadi potjerao dok dvojac ne prihvati kaznu. O odnosima City-evih i United-ovih navijača može nam ispričati moj rođak, kojim je United religija.
And where United Road is, it's where North Stand is now in the corner. And United Road was below and the away fans used to be next door and there was only a fence separating it. And there was so much fighting. In the 80s, so much fighting. You know, I was watching a football match and I had to dodge golf balls, oranges with razors in it. You know, there was so much fighting. Leeds, Liverpool, I remember them two famously. But yeah, bring back a lot of memories, United Road.
But you was 7 years old?
I was a kid. The first time I went to Old Trafford, I went alone and there was a big guy and he put me on his shoulders so I could watch the game, because them days you weren't sitting down, you were standing. And I fell in love with it, and you know, that was...
With this guy or with the...
Everything. Everything about United, still do.
Zamolili smo našeg frenda Joea, kojeg smo pak upoznali preko interneta, da nam pred kameru dofura dva ekstremna navijača, Manchestera i Citya. Ekipu, ono, ultrasa, prvu ekipu, i ona mi dofura ova dva simpatična gospodina, tako on zamišlja, valjda, najžešće navijače.
My wife is a Man City fan. I'm Man United.
There's a, yeah, there's a,
there is rivalry.
There is rivalry, but there's also a lot of friendship and banter, football banter, isn't there?
Yeah, which you picked up from school carried it on.
Yeah.
So although there's a big rivalry, we're still friends after the game.
The main rivalry was always Liverpool, Manchester City. There was rivalry there, but then because there was two big forces winning European Cups in the 70s, that was the main rivalry. Trophy where City were never in the equation. But as time's gone on, things have changed, tables have turned, money investment has gone over to the City side, Glazers more taking out the money, City's putting in the money. But for me, the rivalry will always be United and Liverpool. Still big with City. We don't like them. That's where I stand with it.
Who had the prettiest woman fans?
Oh, United, without a doubt.
Why? Why ugly girls support City?
Let's not go there.
Tell me, you are the City fan.
I would say our fans are just as good looking as United fans, if not better.
Well, most of the United fans, if they play at 3 o'clock, they have to set off at 9 o'clock in the morning because they all live in London. There's no Manchester United fans in Manchester. They're all from London. And the bastards.
City fans, plastic. Plastic.
What's it mean?
No, there for the money, there for the success.
How can I recognize a City fan in the town?
You'll see them wearing blue and crawling, probably.
Why do you support the City?
Why do you support City, George?
Because they're the best team in the world.
Best team in the world.
Really?
Yeah.
What about United?
Rubbish.
What?
Rubbish.
City! City! City!
And the best, one of the best moments in the pub was when we beat them at Main Road. It took me 2 hours to mop the floor. There was more beer on the floor than there was in the taps that day. This place was crazy.
Last question, did you ever punch a City fan?
No. Maybe when I was a kid, probably, but no. Them days are long gone for me, long gone. I'm a businessman now.
Mic po mic, približilo se vrijeme utakmice, no prije nego krenemo na atmosferu u gradu, još jedna mini nogometna bizarnost. Manchester ima ogroman nogometni muzej koji su mnogi naši navijači posjetili, ali jedan eksponat me šokirao.
Yeah, we have Maradona's shirt when he put the ball in with his hand.
Yeah. His shirt is in England.
Yeah.
Do he know about that?
Yeah.
Did you know?
He swapped it with an England player after the drug test.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I'm sure was it Steve.
And this holy grail for Argentina
is here.
Here in Manchester.
Yeah.
Shh, this is secret. You don't want to war with Argentina anymore.
No.
Don't tell that nobody.
Evo ispred nogometnog muzeja, koga nego susjede će sresti?
I'm sorry, so we don't speak Croatian actually. Sorry,
Croatian,
English,
yeah.
To koji već jezik?
Edin Džeko.
Otkud si ti?
Iz Dublina.
Rodom iz Bosne i Hercegovine.
Kojim dobro?
Čuj, bravo.
Pa na utakmicu, eto.
Da, idemo na Empty Heart.
Empty Heart, ja.
Da, čuli smo za ovu izjavu.
Da je Empty Heart zato što nikad tamo nikog nema, pa idemo i mi vidimo.
Results.
2-2.
2 each, yeah. 0-1, ne, za Dinamo, ne? Ono, jaki smo, ne?
Biće zanimljivo. Biće zanimljivo. Jako zanimljivo.
If you don't win 5-0 tonight, I will be disappointed with you.
Mi živimo u Švedskoj. I njemu je, on je punio 40. I to od mene je poklonio od cura za 40. Da dođemo gledati utakmicu.
Evo, vrlo lako je u Manchesteru prepoznat Dinamove navijače, ono, na prvi pogled, sve jasno.
Halo!
Hajde! Okej, nećemo. Bog.
Dinamo.
Dinamo.
Of course, of course. Ne, znači, samo Dinamo. Znači, iako sam u Londonu, Dinamo i dalje sve na svijetu.
Dinamo! Zagreb! Dinamo! Zagreb! Dinamo! Zagreb!
Evo, u obližnjem pubu, kraj Piccadilly Gardena, kupilo se nekoliko navijača Dinama.
Halo, vi kommer från Norge. Vi är Dinamo supporterne. Pral, sinu.
Ja.
I evo, iznenađenje iz Norveške. Slaven, brat Igora Cvitanovića, Cvite. Dinamove legende koji je drugi strjelac u povijesti HNL-a sa 126 golova. Slavene, otkud ti u Norveškoj?
Posao, žena je rekla, može, živjet u Norveškoj, fantazija.
G'day mate, Dinamo je Zagreb supporter from Sydney, Australia.
Was it too long a journey to be here?
28 hours on a plane.
Just for this game?
Yes, just for this game.
Is that it?
Crna nam je duša.
Koji će vam god?
Pa nemam pojma.
To je tako treba.
Dress code.
Dress code je tako.
Da izgledamo za jebanije, šta ja znam. Da izgledamo za jebanije, ne znam. Svako čas večeras i da bi bijediš 2-0 preti Manchester City. Dobro. On you mate, good luck.
Dok su mi čitali knjige po pubovima, u centru se skupila ekipa i zagrijavala glasnice.
Olmo i Petković.
Ovo je Petković, Škarica me skornira.
Škarica me skornira, to se tako.
Olmo će sam sebi nabaciti u gol.
To se tako.
3000 kuna put smještaj će parac, tak negdje. Padli smo avion 550 kuna povratno, iznemali prek Budimpešte. Išli smo u London dva dana.
Kaj ste u Londonu?
Molim?
Kaj ste u Londonu?
U Londonu bili smo čak na tekmi, bili smo na ovom QPR West Bromwich i na Tottenham smo ušli ono za 10 funti prek Crnaca. Prek tamno putih osoba. I Liverpool jučer, danas Manchester, evo.
Čekaj, vi ste tu 5 dana, 20 utakmica ste
pogledali. Pa, to više možemo da iskoristimo. Idemo sutra doma Liverpool Pula i spole ćemo neko doći do Zagreba.
Možda odemo na Istra, ne znam, igra.
Buje, a ne danas je tek.
Ne, to je Rijeka Buje.
I onda iznenadni protunapad domaćih. Nakon što je gospođa pokazala gdje sunce ne sija, što je dečkima preostalo nego da se pokupe i u korteu krenu prema stadionu. Dva
dva i pol sata prije utakmice oko stadiona je prilično prazno. Većina stvari se dešava u gradu, a kao što smo već navikli na europskim utakmicama, ljudi dolaze ko u kazalište 15 minuta prije.
Can you tell me what do you expect today?
A win, obviously.
Win for Man City.
Obviously, yeah. For Manchester City.
What is the results?
3-0.
No, 5-0.
We're hopeful. Bye.
Evo, mladi, zaljubljeni i optimistični.
Pa, di si, moj?
Legenda, si dobar?
Jesam, ti?
Pa, više manje, evo.
Kud vidjet ću?
Mi smo iz Lica došli ovdje, inače smo iz Siska, blizu Zagrebu. Tako da, evo, doletili smo malo pogledat Dinamo Sisi. Radimo.
Diranje?
Pa, u tvornici pakiranja čokolade. Kit Kat i tako to.
Pa još ste mršaju, čekaj da vas vidim.
Misliš?
Koliko ste dobili od kad radite u tvornici?
Pa jedno, 10 kila. Godinu dana. Samo godinu, da. Vraćamo se brzo. Fali nam obitelj, fali nam sve. Da.
Well, it's going to be a tough game tonight, I think we can't underestimate Dinamo Zagreb. I think they're a good attack inside. We've just got to take our time and try and get the goal and get the winning. Come on, City!
I reckon that'll be about 4-0 Man City, maybe 4-1.
I've watched the reserves over there this afternoon. We should have had at least 8 goals and it was 2-2. So, and yet they're very noisy fans. They're about 20 there and they were noisy.
Inumo.
You support?
Yeah.
Come on, United. You and I, TD.
Oh, Wanderers. Wanderers.
Man United, come on.
Dynamo Zagreb.
Nice,
2-0 slash Dynamo.
Do you have no money?
I support Manchester City.
Why?
You know, I support them for more than 50 years.
But you are from
Malta.
Malta.
Where
small
is
island.
Malta, yeah, Malta. In the middle of
you travel all...
Yes, travel.
From Malta, 3 hours and a half. From Malta, from here, from Manchester.
It's not the first time that I came here. And once I was in Malta as a waiter, and the boss said to us, a football team is coming tonight, take care of him. And it was Manchester City. Could you believe that?
And you're falling in love?
Yeah, both of them.
Oh my God.
S obzirom da sad prije tekme na stadionu nema nikoga, morao sam biti prvi koji je skupio hrabrost i ušao. I odmah iznenađenje. Nigdje sokova, a baš se uželio traubi sode. Umjesto toga, ponuda pive, Amstel, Heineken, John Smith i to s 4,1% alkohola.
Ovdje se za vrijeme utakmice očigledno pije i alkoholno pivo. Ono, uvijek slušamo u Europi bez alkohola, za vrijeme utakmice ne, u Engleskoj ne. I ovo je iz Europe još uvijek.
Gledam teren i sjetim se kako nam je jučer Chris govorio da Pep voli što kraću travu i k tome ju polijeva da igra bude što brža. Ko zna hoće li se Dinamo snaći na takvom terenu.
Pitam se zašto su engleske navijačke himne uvijek šlageri. Tako je ovo od Manchester City, a Blue Moon. Jer su najžešći navijači, a ima i takvi, City-a, točno pored najžešćih navijača Dinama. Dakle, Engleska. To bi kod nas bilo nezamislivo, ovdje je sasvim normalna vijeća, da će biti normalno do kraja.
Dinamo! 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 Dinamo!
Mislim da su malo u šoku ovaj navijači City, ali su ovaj, očekivali ovakve manijake. Ovi ne prestaju pjevati, znači koliko je prošlo prvih 10 minuta, ono, ubijeli.
Tako je prvo poluvrijeme završilo bez golova i s nadom da Dinamo može nešto u drugom.
Not very good. Plenty of chances, but should score.
Come on, Jake, get here. Come on, Jake. Come on. Yeah, we Scotsman. Come on, Nick City. First time, shit, but never mind about that. We're going to win 4-0 still, and I've had them all season, and we're going to fucking have it.
Very loud and dangerous as well. They're hanging off the top.
I saw lots of, how can I say, between the fans.
Banter, lots of noise and things like that, really. So that's what Champions League's all about. So Champions League. But they've got a drum. We've got no drum. We've got no drum. So we need a drum.
Oh, yeah.
For this. So.
We've got one behind us.
We've got a drum.
Right behind us.
Yes, okay, come on.
Good fans, good crowd, brought a lot with them. No trouble yet, so. Keep it that way.
Well, what we find now is the European games, the away fans are very, very vocal. Very vocal. Eastern Europeans, always vocal, always loud, always noisy. But it's their away game. It's a good atmosphere. It creates a good atmosphere, and that's what we want. We want a good atmosphere.
The game's not going good. They've got a disciplined back five.
Get it off, VAR. Get it off.
They got a disciplined back five, yeah. I was looking to break through, but this half will break through it. Let them fans are off the reds, and it's got making a good atmosphere. But we'll break through this half, I promise you. We're not losing this game. Champions League's ours this year.
Istanbul,
what's he
say? We are coming. Istanbul, Istanbul, I say. Istanbul, Istanbul, we are coming. We are coming at the end of May.
Dečki moji, pa di je još Istanbul?
6-0. Za Dinamo, naravno. Sad, a do jaja.
Okej, okay, tekma.
5-0 za nas, 5-0 za Dinamo na drugom polu. Rastavit ćemo smradove Engleske.
Saki si u crnom, e. Saki nisi u Havajkama. I'm from Shipket, Germany.
And what you're doing with Bedroom Boys?
One of my friends who live in Germany told me they are playing today against City, so I decided to come with my friend and watch the game together.
Ovo je spektakl. Meni je ovo prvi put da sam na gostovanju. Ovo je spektakl neviđen. Pobjedit ćemo 1-0.
Prvo povreme 0-0, ali bit će sad 3-0. Dobio sam dojavu. Iz prvih redova se dobio. It's so fantastic. I'm so impressed. Because this is my first time seeing so amazing cloud find your team. I'm so amazing.
Ovo mi je prvi put, tako da sam oduševljena.
Nas 1500 je nadglasalo, od njih 30,000. Mogu se sakriti. Oni nisu ni od navijača.
Dinamo Zagreb!
Drugo polovreme je krenulo. Istrčim na tribinu i odmah šok. Ljudi, pa ovaj beton je od gume.
Lijepo navijanje, ali se trese gornja tribina.
Nažalost, eto gola. Ali par čaša i poljevanja sa Cityjeve tribine na Dinamove navijače, što je dodatno zagrijalo i zapalilo atmosferu. Nažalost, drugi je gol pokopao sve nade. 2-0, rezultat je kojim je i utakmica završila. Domaći su navijači nestali u par minuta, dok su Dinamovi ostali pozdraviti igrače. Mi smo otišli u mix zonu, gdje već čekao zaovine jetrve Friend iz Koreje.
What is your goal here?
To have interview with Orsic. Orsha. Orsha used to play in Korea. Many of Korean fans was fabulous when he scored and three times against Atlanta in his Champions League debut.
Is he bigger than Lady Gaga in Korea?
I don't think so, sorry.
Is he bigger than Gangnam Style?
No way. But as a foreign player, Orsic was one of the best for certain Pell fans. It's definitely true.
I thought Dynamo Moses group played really well. We come every week to the Manchester City Stadium, and a lot of English teams struggle. They are so good, and you know, Zagreb is not one of the giant teams of Europe, so we kind of thought, well, they would struggle. But I understand they didn't do a lot of attacking, but I thought they were competitive, and you know, they did their best.
Utakmica koji svaka druga, možda u ovoj je bilo najmanje za izgubiti, tako da i pritisak u samoj utakmici nije bio velik kao u nekim utakmicama koje moraš pobijediti. Tako da neće biti problematičan oporavak, svi znamo protiv kakve ekipe smo igrali, oni su pokazali svoju klasu, svoju moć i svoju snagu na terenu. Tako da nisam razočaran za poslije utakmice u kojoj moja ekipa ne da sve na terenu, mislim da su moji dečki dali sve, pa onda zbog toga će biti oporavak brzo.
Šta ćeš od nenogometnih dojmova ponesti?
Pa... Ne znam, cijeli fokus je prije utakmice i to.
Ne znam, slačionica, da li ti se svidjela? Ljudi, atmosfera, stadion.
Teren je odličan, takvih nemamo pa.
Stvarno?
Da.
Po čemu je odličan?
Trava je, tepi.
Jučer smo snimali na stadionu i onda smo rekli jedan interesantan podatak. Da Guardiola traži da se trava pošiša na minimuma što je dozvoljeno, da bi igra bila što brža.
Još ga
se to uopće osjetilo danas?
Još ga prskaju pred utakmicu. Pa normalno, on ima igrače sa najvišom kvalitetom koji postoje u svjetskom nogometu i puno je lakše napadati protiv ovakvih ekipa kao mi koje se brane kad je teren brz i kad je lopta brza, imaju vrhunsku kontrolu lopte, tako da im to daje određenu prednost.
Na kraju se došao pozdraviti navijači, kako je zadovoljno s navijačima?
Pa svakam čast, veliko hvala, čuli ste cijelu utakmicu, došli su nas bodriti i stvarno veliko hvala.
Čuli smo ih više nego njihove, tako da stvarno podrška je bila odlična.
Da imate zlatnu ribicu i da možete jednog igrača uzeti za iduću godinu za Dinamo, koji bi to bio?
Iz Cityja.
Naravno. Ja ću vam to sretiti.
Zadovoljan sam ja sa mojim dečkima.
No, recimo jedan ekstra.
Jedan ekstra? Pa ne znam. Evo Rodrija. Rodrija. Da, stvarno. Onako, ona šestica, vrhunska šestica koja u svakom trenutku radi sve na najbolji mogući način. I u fazi napada i u fazi obrane, stvarno je perfektno. Nisam znao da je tako dobro.
A što Rodrigo kaže? Spremali kofere za Hrvatsku?
Personally, I like to be in Croatia lots of times in summer. I think once, you know, with the cruiser. With the cruiser, I stopped once in Dubrovnik, and looks very, very, very good. I love it. But I want to visit more, you know, more definitely the country and be more days because I enjoy it.
Da ne bude sam, Rodrigo bi mogao povesti Gvardiolu koji već navodno kratko i bio u Dubrovniku.
Did you try Croatian happy water?
Rakija?
Yeah. Yeah.
And how was the feeling?
That was good. It was good. It was good. All the countries from Mediterranean I love it because the weather is nice, the food is perfect. I think the people is happy. So, yeah. Maybe, you know, because I went there, but stay, you know, 1 week, 10 days, that is when I didn't do that. Maybe in the future I can do it.
Ovo ipak tužno javljanje iz Manchestera zaključit ćemo s optimizmom Dinamovog kapetana.
Mi ćemo nastaviti borbu, nastavit ćemo, da ćemo sve od sebe da pokušamo proći. I ja vjerujem u ekipu i vjerujem da mi to možemo.
Hvala lijepo na gledanju, idemo dalje. Nema predaje!
Pripremili Robert Knjaz i prijatelji.